Hello once again and welcome to the second session of this tutorial. So we'll be starting from where we left off. Now we are going to connect a JSP page to our application. In this session, the output of the video will be something looking like this. We'll be having a login page with this name, with these fields and all, and a navigation bar. So let's start. Now we are going to create one more method, and that method will return this page. This page it will return, this method will return. So let's write it. Public string welcome. Return also, you know, you have to add an annotation called request mapping. Now we have mapped our this page, but we don't have this page, so we can create a JSP page with this same name, welcome page. Okay, so JSP page, where we should create the JSP page. So basically, our by default it is configured, or Spring Boot is configured with this folder, like templates, static pages, templates. We can keep the pages here, but we'll be using one more method. We'll be making one new folder. And we'll name this folder as web app. And in web app we'll be making one more folder with name web inf, and in web inf we'll make one more folder for our JSP pages, and that we will name it as view. You can give any name. And one more thing, you have to place a web in web app, you have to place one more folder, that is resources. Okay, so now in this view folder we will create a JSP page. So you have to click new and others. You have to type here JSP file, next, and you have to name this JSP file. Make sure you are configuring your JSP file in the proper location, web app, web inf, view, and we want to put our JSP file in view. And also we will name this JSP file same name as whatever you have given it in our application welcome page. Next and finish. So we got our JSP page here. Next, what we can do, this JSP page has to be configured with our application. So in order to do that, our project will require some of the dependencies, and these dependencies are let's search on internet. For searching a dependency, you have to go to Maven repository. And you have to type here Tomcat Jasper. So here we got Tomcat embed Jasper. Click on this link and you can select any. These are the version. Latest version will be listed at the top. You can take any versions. For now I'm taking this version. So you will get something like this. Maven will be here, something like this. In the dependency form you will get. Just copy this and go to your application. Open form.xml and in the dependencies, this is dependencies. Inside you have to provide anywhere you can keep these dependencies. Suppose I'm keeping it here. For formatting in Fury using Eclipse or STS, for formatting this code you have to give a shortcut Control Shift F, so it will format. It will increase readability of your code. Now you can see something here. This is the problem. If you are getting any problem like this in your pom.xml, that means that your application will not run. We can do one thing. We can remove this, give a tag called scope. And in scope you can type provided. So you have added this dependency here now. And also you require one more dependency for running the JSP page in a Spring Boot application. That dependency is called starter Tomcat, something like that. Spring Boot starter Tomcat. So you can go here, you can choose it, copy, and you can go and paste it here anywhere. Save it. Overriding managed dependencies. So let's remove this line. It now it's fine. Actually, I have already downloaded this dependency, the correct version, and that's why it was giving error. Now what we can do now? We have to update this application. Let's go to Maven, update project, select your project and update it. It's updating, it's showing here. Okay, now project it updated and let's deploy it. It's my application, this one. Let's go to the browser and we will type. So we got 404 error again. So now what we can do, we have downloaded our required dependencies also and still our application is not running. That means something else we need to configure. So what we needs to be configured, see here we are keeping our JSP file not in the default location. The default location is this one, templates, static, but we are keeping our JSP file in some other location. So we have to tell explicitly that we are keeping it here. That we will be doing using application.properties file will be here in resources. You have to open your application.properties, and there you can provide like where are your JSP pages. You have to mention it here. So for that, we have some specific methods. We have to follow that, and we have to remember that, because all the time we'll be using that method, we have to remember it. That is spring.mvc.view.prefix. So everything will be small letters, because to you have to provide your this path after the web app, that is webinf. View okay, you have provided the prefix, also you have to provide the suffix. .jsp. So we have configured it. Let's open our welcome.jsp page. We have not given anything yet, so let's insert a title. So our channel name, and let's give a heading h1. JSP page, welcome from JSP page. Now guess we have done everything, all the configuration. Now let's run this again. We should deploy it. And we have deployed it. Now go back here and run it. So this time we got welcome from JSP.